My name is Karen Johnson. I served in the Arizona State Legislature for 12 years. I was in the House for 8 of those years and in the Senate for 4 of those years. When you see a plane fly overhead, there's a trail that leaves the end of that plane, and it goes from one horizon all the way to the other as the plane flies across, and it begins to filter out and cover more and more of the sky in kind of ripples. It widens out and fills the whole sky. I mean, how could anybody think that that was the case? And then to live and to be underneath that and know that whatever is in that is falling down upon you and upon your animals and upon the earth. And I mean, it's frightening to me. And if people don't start really waking up and facing the fact that we've got people that are doing terrible things to us, and we had better wake up and fight back now. I mean, I'm the mom of 11 kids. I've got 35 grandkids. I mean, I've got a stake in this. I care about what is going to be left for my children. I care about it, and I'm extremely worried about what is going to be left to them.
These kind of linings remain for entire day. If you know, you might have observed a white powder before. Few months back, there was all white powder on the cars, on the road and all. So people were panicking what this white powder is. So do you feel there can be any connection in between these two?
The concern is off the charts about why is this happening? Why is this being allowed to be sprayed continually all over the United States, all over the world? Who is paying for this? I mean, the incidence of Alzheimer's has just skyrocketed, which evidently has to do with an accumulation of aluminum in the brain cells. I mean, I think almost every family has been touched by a member as they get older having Alzheimer's. And it's a horrible disease. And to say that, well, this just came because people drank soda pop out of aluminum cans, you know, when my father passed away with Alzheimer's and he didn't ever drink soda pop, you know, that explanation doesn't ring true with me. And so I'm wondering, how much did this chemtrail spraying back in the Illinois area affect him? These are parts per million. They sent this to me, and I just found this to be extremely interesting, because we should have like 2 parts per million of aluminum in our air. And this is saying that there's 39,000 parts of aluminum. That's astronomical. Barium is high. I mean, these are way off the charts of what people should be breathing or what's coming down on them. And, you know, if people wonder why their health is deteriorating, why they're having to go to emergency rooms, why they can't breathe, you know, why they're getting Alzheimer's, this has been planned. We have elites, I don't know what you want to call them, One Worlders, Illuminati, I don't know, whatever you want to call them. But with these people that don't care about the average person. They only care about themselves, their greed, their power. You know, I've heard different explanations about, oh, we need to cool the planet, all this and that. But if people are up there trying to cool the planet, why do they need all this kind of stuff in it? The explanations just never have really rang very true. If they eliminate, you know, 2/3, 3/4 of us from the planet, so much for the better for them, because then they don't have so many people to have to herd around and worry about. So this is a lot what this is about. And this is very, very alarming and scary. Don't you feel better when you stand up and fight than if you crawl down in a little hole and go to sleep? You know, I mean, my gosh, people, your families are out there, children are out there, your grandchildren. I mean, you've got to do something to help.
You know, it's interesting because of the different weather modification programs. There's something like, I think, right around 32 in the continental U.S. alone going on. So the theory is that geoengineering is in part weather modification.
You know, Mike, that's a very good point. There are so many subsets connected with this issue of geoengineering. People are writing to us all the time with information about the connection to global warming, the connection to weather modification. Some people think there's a connection with Morgellons disease. Others think it's kind of a means of transmitting electromagnetic impulses from the HARP antenna system up in Alaska and Siberia. Boy, it gets your head spinning. And each area, I think, is worthy of investigation, but we have so little time. I think it's wise for us to stay focused on just the aerospraying and the toxic effect of these chemicals, and the destruction of the planet, and the damage to human health. What more do you need than that to convince people that we have to put a stop to it? So to stay focused, I think, is our mission on this one.
It could be some harmful chemicals, or we don't know. Okay, so do you think that we should check on this? What exactly is this?
Yeah.
We should check.
And I can't remember if it was in LA or if I was on the road, but I had looked up one day and I thought, look at that. That's not the flight path, man. That was a regular grid over the city, and I couldn't believe my eyes.
Milky white clouds.
And, you know, it all seems very obvious, and now the evidence of what we have on the ground with the aluminum, the barium, strontium, and with what we see in the patents and what the geoengineers say are going to happen, I mean, for the everyday Joe, this is a slam dunk.
The knowledge of what's coming is taking its toll on me. I see all these people living their lives, enjoying themselves, planning their futures. I'm oblivious to the fact that it's all going to end soon. Here I am at a park where children are playing, and in the skies above, I can see the chemtrails poisoning the air and slowly killing us all in plain sight. I've never felt so helpless. I want to scream out to the world, but I don't want to be laughed at, ridiculed. When Claire said the memoirs were a fabrication, I secretly wish she was right. Then I could sleep at night. But I know, beyond a reasonable doubt, that it's all true. It's more of a deeply concerned confession. He was scared for us all. And that says a lot, coming from a man who was a government assassin. A one-world government will immediately form without any resistance from the people. They will be the new world order. Once this happens, we as a people will be doomed to enslavement and accelerated depopulation. With that said, the only hope for human salvation is to acquire and spread the knowledge of these activities and agendas. Resist, retaliate, then conquer this imposing enemy. The time is now, as humanity is rapidly approaching its final days.